And we're back with our panel of Fil-Am Republican leaders to discuss last night's RNC program. Thanks again for joining us, Rudy Asercion, with the San Francisco Republican Central Committee and healthcare business owner, Nympha Gámez. Now, we saw former Acting Director of National Intelligence, Richard Grenell, speak last night on foreign policy. Today, there is global concern about the erosion of democracy in the Philippines. Now, what do you think will U.S.-Philippines relations look like under 4 more years of the Trump administration? I'll start with you, Rudy.
I think President Trump will be best for the Philippine relation, because I know he's going to honor the visiting forces agreement, and I know he's going to honor the mutual agreement between the Philippines, the mutual defense treaty. And an example of that is this is the first time that the America has sent 3 aircraft carriers in the South China Sea, which has never been done before. And basically, Mr. Trump is ending Mr. Obama's policy of appeasement, and that's one thing that I like about the president.
All right, for you, Nympha, I mean, what do you expect in terms of foreign relations with the U.S. and the Philippines for another 4 years under the Trump administration?
You know, President Trump is a wise business manager. He managed big businesses, and so he can manage our country, he can manage our economy. And I know that he's a take charge president, and he will for sure be able to stand up against China. Because right now, the Philippines is in trouble with China. They're trying to acquire our islands. And President Trump is the only president who could stand up to them because of his personality. I'm sure, being a good businessman, he knows what is good for the healthcare field in the United States. And he knows that, like what we've been doing in the past, America is always outsourcing for our nurses, you know, for our workers in the healthcare field.
All right, thank you. Now, to wrap this up, of course, everyone's anticipating, eager to see President Trump tonight formally accept the Republican presidential nomination and give a speech that, they all want to see him at least match or surpass the effectivity of what Joe Biden did last week. For you, if there's just one issue that you really hope to see in the long list of things that he will highlight tonight, what would be the most important one for you that would really help speak to this nation and would convince them that this is the guy that should lead America for another 4 years? And I'll end this with you, Nympha. Go ahead.
I want to see him as the true father of the nation, like he has been doing now. He's not siding with just one movement. He's not doing things to favor one movement or one racial issue. He's doing everything for the whole of America. Like in his speeches, he is America first. And we Fil-Ams are part of that country, of this country. You know, our issues, our children, my grandchildren, are part of America. So he is fighting for all of us, what is good for everybody, for the common tao, for the common good. He will make America and keep America great again.
Thank you, Nympha. Now, Rudy, for you, what is the number one issue that you would love to see President Trump address tonight as he addresses the nation?
Well, the number one issue right now is because of the result of the pandemic that's been brought here from China. I want the president to be cognizant of the first thing that America needs is to fix the economy and return the low jobless rate to the pre-pandemic level. And quite frankly, to boost the American confidence so that we can recover after the COVID-19. But there are some very, very interesting things that Mr. Trump has been doing, and I'd really like for him to continue, foremost of which is returning the manufacturing back to the United States. As you know, 90% of our pharmaceutical drugs and prescription drugs are being manufactured from China. And should China stop that, we're going to be in trouble. So the fact that he is investing a lot of resources to bring jobs back and manufacturing back to the United States from China is very, very important to Americans.
All right. Thank you so much. We really appreciate your time and your candidness. Nympha and Rudy, very insightful perspectives today. Thank you for helping us out tonight, and we really appreciate you spending some time with us. Mga Kapamilya, we'll be back with more community perspectives tomorrow as we continue and wrap up our coverage of the RNC.